Hello, welcome to this tutorial video. In this I'm going to show you how to make a bar chart and a line chart using Excel. This is an introductory video for someone who may have never used Excel before. So the first thing I'm going to have to do is pull in Excel and open that. And I'm going to open up a blank document. Here we go. All right, so there is a lot that you can actually do with Excel, but we're going to start with the absolute beginnings. So I'd like to make a bar chart. I've been comparing the annual tuition and fees at Arizona State University, Northern Arizona University, University of Arizona, and MCC. And I want to make a chart to demonstrate the differences in the tuition costs. So what I'm going to do is enter my data into two columns. The first column is going to be the column that is the school name, and the second is going to be the column that's got the annual tuition and fees. So let's get started. First, we go to A1, which is where I'm going to write the word school. Underneath that, I'm going to click with my mouse into A2, and I'm going to write ASU. Now I can either take my mouse and direct it to A3, or I can just press enter and that will take my cursor to the next space to enter NAU, enter U of A, and MCC. Now I'm going to enter the data for annual tuition and fees. Now one thing to note is that in the data that you're going to be plotting, you don't actually want to put the dollar sign next to your number. So we'll put that up in the title. So I'm going to write annual tuition and fees. And in brackets, I'm going to put dollars. Whoops. Now you'll notice that the title is actually bigger than the column size. So one thing you can do is you can take your cursor up to the column between B and C, and where it forms the double arrow, you can then click and drag to increase the size of that column. The next thing that you can do is add in your data. So we've got $9,861 is the annual tuition and fees for ASU. $9,738 is the tuition for NAU. $10,391 is U of A, and $1,970 is MCC. So now I'd like to make a graph. So what you need to do is you need to select all of your data with your cursor and go to Insert. And what you'll see is it has a variety of different recommended charts. Now I'd like to make a bar chart. That's one that's got vertical bars. So I'm going to click over here. It says insert column or bar chart. In Excel, they call it a column chart, and they differentiate that from a bar chart. So if you click on that tab, you'll see that you've got several options. You've got a 2D column, a 3D column, a 2D bar, and a 3D bar. In biology, we prefer to have vertical bars versus horizontal bars. It's easier to see how much of an item is accumulated in a category when it's vertical. So let's choose a 2D column. You just click on that and your graph will automatically make itself. So that's quite nice. But there are a few things that are wrong with this graph. It doesn't have a nice title and it doesn't have labels for the horizontal and vertical axis. So let's add those in. I'm going to click on the plus sign for chart elements. I want to add chart elements. I'm going to click axis titles. And you'll notice that they automatically populate on your graph. Now this one is oriented a little bit funny so that it can be read vertically. So what I'm going to do, oops, I deleted it by accident. You can go back here and click axis titles and it'll come back again. So let me take my cursor there and backspace to take away those words, and I want to put annual tuition and fees in dollars. Make sure you spell things correctly on your axis titles. There's nothing sloppier than spelling mistakes in the middle. All right, now our horizontal axis title is going to be schools. For our graphs title, annual tuition and fees is not very descriptive, So maybe we might want to write something like a comparison of costs of attending Arizona colleges. Very nice. Okay. Now that's great. You can save your file. Save it on the desktop. Oops, Excel tutorial. And now you can always access that entire workbook again whenever you want. But in our class, oftentimes we'll ask you to insert a graph into Microsoft Word. So let's open up a new blank document in Microsoft Word so that I can show you how to transport your graph from Excel into Microsoft Word. Okay, so we'll click back into Excel. Now I'll take my cursor and I'll select the whole chart area. And then now I'm going to want to copy it. So I'm going to go to right click, whoops, copy. Over to Microsoft Word, insert, no, paste, paste special. Let's paste it as a picture. And there you have it, figure one, nice and neat. We can get ready for figure two, which is coming next. So then you'd want to make sure that you save your Word document. And we press save. Great. Well, now you've made a bar chart, otherwise known as a column chart in Excel. The next thing to do is to learn how to make a line chart. I'm going to do that on a separate sheet within the same document. So I'll go back to the bottom and click New Sheet, because we're a new blank sheet. This new graph that I want to plot is the temperature based on the time of day in the afternoon. So we live in Arizona, it's very hot. I want to tell my family whether or not it'll get cool enough to be able to play outside. So in my first column, I'm going to put time of day. Let's make that column a little bit bigger. In the second column, I'm going to put temperature. And it's important to put your units here. These are degrees Fahrenheit. Make that column nice and white too. Okay, so the time of day, I went on to weather.com or something like that, and I pulled hourly data. So from 1 p.m., 2 p.m., 3 p.m., and so on. And the temperature at 1 p.m. today is going to be 104, 106, 108. We've got quite most of the afternoon. At 6 p.m., it's going to get a little bit cooler. Okay, so there's our graph. Now, I'm going to want to make a line graph. That means that I want to plot each XY coordinate, and then I want to link them together with straight lines. I'm not looking for a trend line. I'm looking to follow the trend of the data over time. So as you can see, if you start low, it's going to get higher, and then it should get lower again. So that's what we're expecting. So let me select time of day, and got all that data selected. We go to insert, and now we can go to charts. So Excel gives you some options. You can either do a line chart, or you can do an Excel XY scatter and link them together. So I'll show you each version. So you can do, let's see, is it going to work? No. One thing I want you to realize is that they're constantly changing the availabilities of different sorts of graphs. So, you know, don't stress out. You can always change graph types in just a heartbeat and find something that makes sense for the data that you've got. So here, this one has plotted the XY coordinates and it's linked them together so you can tell where they are. This one here just links them together without indicating where the points are. And I think I'd like to see the points, so let's choose this one. I want to point out a couple of extra components to the graph once we've added our axis titles. So your vertical title is going to be temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. And your horizontal axis is going to be time in the afternoon. Otherwise, you might think it's 1 a.m., not 1 p.m. And then the title, temperature profile during the afternoon on 7/27/2016 in Mesa, Arizona. So that's a very specific title. Okay, so if we select this graph, notice that you've got some options up here which are quite fun. You can change the color of your graph, so if you really like a different color, you can choose a monochromatic blue if you like. And then you can even change the general appearance of your graph. That one looks quite nice. So does that. Looks very different. Let's choose this one. So you've got options for styles. And that's a way to make your data your own. Let's transfer this now to our Word document so we can be finished with this. So what I'm going to do is make sure that I click on my graph, right click to copy it, go back down here to Word and choose paste. Special, we're pasting as a picture. And there we have it. Press save, and your work is saved. So now you've been shown how to make a bar chart and a line chart in Excel, as well as get an idea that there are some options for personalizing graphs very easily. And I hope that this makes your life just a little bit easier.